You may be familiar with this clip from the Amazing Race TV show. And you may be wondering, how did she not die? Really, a watermelon can easily weigh 10 pounds, and that could easily have been going 30 miles an hour or more. Let's do an analysis and run some numbers. From this video footage, we can actually estimate all the things we need to find impact force. This footage was shot at 30 frames per second. I estimated that the distance from her face to the center of the catapult is about 10 feet. The watermelon covers this distance in 6 frames, which is about 0.2 seconds. This means that the watermelon is traveling about 50 feet per second, or about 15 meters per second when it collides with her face. We can also estimate the contact time duration. The watermelon appears to stay in contact for 3 frames, which would be about 0.1 seconds. Lastly, we need the mass of the watermelon. Looking at this clip here, these watermelons look smaller than average. I'd guess these are about 10 inches long, so probably more like 6 kilograms in mass, or around 13 pounds. Putting this all together, we get an impact force of just 900 newtons. In a previous video, we estimated that about 3,700 to 5,500 newtons of blunt impact force was needed to potentially cause death. So this is not within our range for death, but probably a good concussion, which is really all she walked away with. This watermelon scenario actually points out a really important part of our impact force equation, contact time duration. If our watermelon behaved more like our baseball and remained in contact for only 0.001 seconds, we quickly go from 900 newtons to 90,000 newtons, a huge difference. This is why hard and soft objects make such a huge difference in these situations. Soft objects lengthen the contact time, dissipating the amount of energy being experienced over a longer amount of time and lower the average and peak impact force. This makes surviving these impacts much more likely, and this is why boxers wear gloves, gymnasts tumble on mats, batting helmets have foam pads, and cars have built-in crumple zones. So if you've ever wondered if getting hit in the face by a slingshot watermelon could kill you, now you know. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.